Welcome to the another exciting episode of Startup Saturday, your premier source of the hottest trends and game-changing innovation in the startup world. So, let's get started. Marine robotics startup IROV has raised INR 10 crore in a pre-series A round led by a Unicorn India venture. Founded in 2016 by a John Stemethay and a Kanappa Palippan, the Kochi-based company specializes in marine robotics and AI. IROV plans to use the funds of International Pension and Product Development, known for its underwater drones and unnamed surface vehicles. IROV serves sectors such as energy, defense, and maritime. The company has completed over 100 underwater inspections for clients like Tata, Adani, BPCL, DRDO, and the Indian Coast Guard. IROV aims to triple its revenue by the end of the fiscal year, expanding its market presence in India in the MENA region. Next, Bengaluru-based Servum AI has launched a suite of generative AI product backed by investors like Lightspeed and PeakXV. Their platform supports 10 Indian languages and offers both enterprise and open source solutions. Key products include Servum Agent, voice-enabled AI assistant available at ₹1 per minute for sectors like financial services and telecom, and Servum 2TB, an open source language model trained 4 trillion tokens. They have also introduced Ashoka 1.0, which extends Meta AI Llama 8B model for audio support in Indian languages and AI. A generative AI workbench for a legal profession. Rural fintech startup Jai Kishan has received the Reserve Bank of India's approval to acquire a majority stake in Kushal Finnovation Capital Private Limited, an NBFC. This acquisition will enable Jai Kishan to design and distribute a broader range of credit products tailored for farmers and rural businesses. Through its NBFC subsidiary, the startup plans to originate loans and a co-lend with financial institutions, including public sector banks. Jai Kishan has built a digital ecosystem connecting corporates, rural intermediaries, and financial services to facilitate supply chain financing and buy now pay later option for crop inputs and equipment. Before we jump back in, let me know if you enjoyed this video with a big thumbs up. Smash that subscribe button and stay on top of all things tech. Hey, why you should subscribe? IT Voice is a one-stop show for the latest startup news. We cover everything from emerging companies to the hottest trends and in the industry. We deliver fresh, in-depth content. Stay ahead of the curve and understand how startups are shaping our digital world. Hit that subscribe button and join the IT Voice community today. Moving to legal tech, Mumbai-based firm Lex Legis has introduced a Lex Legis AI, positioning it as India's answer to Huawei AI. This tool trained on 1 crore legal documents spanning 25 years aim to simplify legal research and streamline information extraction from professionals. Founded in 1998, Lex Legis has a history of pioneering legal tech solutions, including India's largest database of judgment. Lex Legis AI initially focused on tax law, but plans to expand it to all legal fields, offering an Indian-made large language, a model dedicated to the Indian legal system. The AI aims to significantly reduce the time spent on a legal research and a citation retrieval, benefiting legal professionals and businesses alike. In the electric vehicle sector, Kinetic Green has raised $25 million from Greater Pacific Capital as a part of its ongoing Series A round, targeting a total of $40 million. Founded in 2016, Kinetic Green plans to use this funding to scale up production at its Supa Maharashtra facility, enhance marketing efforts, and invest in R&D. The company aims to sell over 100,000 vehicles next year and pending internationally, including a premium golf cart line developed with the Lamborghini family. This investment aligns with India's 2030 EV goals and the country's energy transition efforts. GPCS Ketan Patel emphasized Kinetic Green's potential in driving India's energy transition. Google Cloud, under Sundar Pichai's leadership, plans to establish a startup hub in the center of excellence in Madhya Pradesh, announced by CM Mohan Yadav at the Invest Madhya Pradesh session in Bengaluru. This initiative is a part of a larger investment trend in the state, which has received proposals from ₹3,200 crore expected to create 7,000 jobs. The state is also exploring collaboration with Hindustan Aeronautics Limited for an aerospace and defense development wing. While NVIDIA has proposed a positioning Madhya Pradesh as the intelligence capital of India. Lastly, mobility tech startup Blue Blue Binaries has raised ₹60 crore from Anicut Capital. Founded in 2017, the company specializes in accelerating the development of software-defined vehicles, leveraging ties in EE Architect, cloud computing, AI, ML, cybersecurity, and IoT, serving clients across Europe, the UK, USA, and Asia Pacific. Blue Binaries is poised to capitalize on automotive electronic and software market, projected to exceed $80 billion by 2030. This funding will strengthen their customer base and enhance their technological capabilities in the rapidly evolving mobility sector. That's all for today's startup news. We have seen some exciting developments and challenges in the tech world. Keep following us for more updates and insight into the ever-evolving startup landscape. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe for the latest news and information in the startup world. Stay tuned to IT Voice for more tech updates.